You are being fooled by footballers, and I'm going to be telling you how, why, and who is doing it. Now, there's a few things I'm going to be showing you in today's video, including the dirtiest tricks that footballers use. But first up, we're going to be taking a look at commercials. So I've said it before that a lot of these football adverts are fake, and I just get a load of comments calling me a hater. So today I'm going to be proving it and showing you exactly how they're done. And this includes working out exactly how that famous Ronaldinho crossbar challenge was filmed.
So the first thing we're going to look at is this clip from Ozil that was made by Adidas. You can just tell the movements aren't really natural and it's clearly fake. This is how they did it.
I feel like this is going to be quite difficult, but we've got a few ideas and we should film a lot and hopefully it can be done in the edit.
Let's just pause it there. Unfortunately, I'm not talented enough to do this alone, so I'll be passing the hours of editing for these clips over to John Farnworth. But don't worry, I'll show some clips of the editing process as we go.
Right, Ewan, you're going to go over there and you're basically just pinging it in as I'm pinging it.
So first things first, I'll attempt the shot as normal and celebrate as if I'd just done it for real.
Yes! Get in!
Then I got a few shots of the ball going into the net from different heights and angles. After that, I pinged a few balls across the goal at different heights just to give John some options when it comes to editing. And finally, we needed to get the sound effect of the balls hitting together.
Oh! So one more thing, I need to hit the ball so it goes wide of the goal. Yes! There it is. All right, I think that's everything. Hopefully this works.
So I sent the footage over to John, who put it all together. And this was the final clip.
Yes. Get in. Now this next clip is an interesting one. And it's funny how Dortmund are saying it's real.
And Dortmund tweeted this video of him at training earlier. Dortmund say the footage is real. Judge for yourselves. What a performance there from Haaland.
Now this Haaland clip has recently gone viral and somehow people believe it, despite that it's literally impossible to balance three balls on top of each other, let alone the rest of the trip.
This is how that clip was really done.
So I started off by just pretending to do the whole clip as if the balls were balanced on top of each other. As you can see, I had Ewan running in to help me out and he'll be masked out by John later in the edit. But all we needed was to make sure that there was a shot of all three balls balanced on top of each other so they could be freeze framed by John. Then Ewan came in and cleared the shot before I pretended to keep the balls at the target.
Yes, there's one. Two. Final one. Get in.
The final thing I needed was to hit the target with each one of the different balls, which to be fair actually took me quite a while and the lighting changed at this point, so hopefully it still works. But I'm guessing that Haaland wouldn't have actually needed to do this part. They probably got someone else to spend their time hitting the targets as they won't be seen on camera.
Yes! Alright, I think we've done that. We'll send it to the edit and see how it looks.
And this was the final edit.
Okay. Yes, there's one.
There's one.
Two.
Yes!
Final one.
Get it. Now, I don't know about you, but I think that looked pretty decent. Now, the next trick is a big one, and actually pretty simple.
So, from that, you probably know, next up, we're doing the famous, one of the most famous fake trick shots, the Messi one. This is how we're gonna do it.
Everyone knows this Messi shot. The bottle flip through the tire looks super cool. And to be fair, Messi definitely could do this, but it would just take him ages and a bit of luck.
He hit it through a tire, but we don't have a tire, so. So I think what I've got to do, put this on here, kick it, make sure the ball goes through the hoop, and then we'll worry about the bottle afterwards.
So yeah, for this one, I basically just ignored the bottle. All I had to do is focus on getting a shot of the ball going through the hoop. Oh.
Get it. Okay.
And then I got a separate shot of the bottle flipping over.
There we go. Okay, now a clean shot. Hopefully, all this will work. Get it. Kieran, why on earth would these super talented, world famous footballers fake their tricks?
The thing is, in advertising, there's lots of money to be made, and the more eyes in the advert, the better. But it's not always easy to get the attention of millions of people, even if you've got a world famous footballer at your disposal.
So instead of getting Messi to jump in front of camera and do a few around the world, which realistically isn't that impressive, It'd be far more beneficial for the brand to create some eye-catching video that would get people talking and sharing the clip on social media, and that's exactly what happened with this next clip.
Right, so this next trick I want to try and do is one from Royce. It actually looks proper sick.
So for this one, Royce pings the ball in the air and then kicks the ball so it hits the ball into the top corner. Quite complicated, but I'm sure you understand what I mean. The physics of this are just all wrong, so it's definitely fake, and this is how it's done.
Right, so I am slightly confused by this one, I'm not going to lie. I'm not sure this one's going to work. We'll try it out though.
Oh, no.
Wait, which ball goes in the goal?
Yeah, this will be the one that I kick in the air. That ball. No, so this one will then hit this. That hits the green ball. Because that's the only physical way it would work.
Oh yeah, sure. Yeah.
For this trick, I'll do a shot pretending that the ball went in. Then I got a few shots of the ball going in the top corner. Although I've just noticed that I was kind of blocking the shot from the camera, so this might be a problem when it comes to editing. Finally, I got the sound of the balls hitting together, and this is the final edit.
Right, Royce trick shot, here we go.
So I think this one looked good, not quite as natural as the original clip, but not too bad.
Right, we're doing this Neymar clip next.
Now this clip is terrible quality, but a young Neymar scores from his own cross. Even Usain Bolt couldn't run that fast. Here's how it was really done.
Okay, I think from what I understand, we're gonna need two balls. Ewan, you're gonna need to chip one into me, but we need to put this on 120 frames per second, so.
Now for this one, I'll ping the ball into the box and run onto it. And when I'm about to reach the goal, Ewan will ping a ball in so that I can volley it into the goal. Even editing couldn't make that shot look good. I must have tried this about 15 times, sprinting to the box, trying to get the perfect timing, and honestly, I was knackered. But eventually, we got one that I think will work.
Yeah! I think we've done it.
Now finally, we take a look at the most famous viral football clip of all time. The Ronaldinho crossbar shot. And to this day, people are still debating whether this clip's real or fake. Well, it's fake. I hate to break it to you as it's so iconic, but realistically, I think by now most people do know that this is not real and not possible. But interestingly, no one from Nike has ever actually admitted that it's fake, which I actually kind of like.
Let's take a look at it and see if we can work out how it's done. So I listened to an interview with a Nike marketing employee, and he basically said that this was a last minute decision by Nike. They had these boots, they didn't have enough time or money to promote them, so they decided to make a quick little video like this. It turns out to be one of their most successful ad campaigns of all time. And fun fact, the pitch where this is filmed in Barcelona, I've actually been on there, so interesting fact. Here's a picture of that. Boom, off the crossbar. I mean, it's done well, it's faked well, I must admit. I think we can do this. I need to speak to John and see what he's saying, but I'm pretty sure we know how to do this.
So for this Ronaldinho trick, we need three identical footballs.
So after trying to do this for real a few times, I decided that faking it would definitely be easier.
Right, this is take one of the Ronaldinho shot. You'll see what we're gonna do in a sec. Yep.
The only thing is that ball rolled back into shot.
So as you can see, I would kick the ball at the bar and then Ewan would throw another ball in as if it was coming from the crossbar back to me, and then we'd do this three times, and in the edit it would hopefully all be fixed and look really good.
Take number three.
This actually took me quite a while, yep, as I kept miscontrolling the ball when it was thrown back to me. But I'm guessing this only took Ronaldinho like one take, because his touch, well, it's fairly decent.
Let's turn that off, yeah. We've just had a go doing the Ronaldinho one. I think we've done it. We'll have to depend on the edit now, but I think it looked okay.
So there was a really long editing process for this one, but here is the final edit.
Now for this final section of the video, I'm going to be showing you five of the dirtiest tricks that footballers use to get an advantage on the pitch.
Trick number one is the oldest trick in the book, the shirt pull. It helps to slow the opposition down and break up a counter-attack. But also, when pinning a defender, it'll help keep them behind you. Also, out of all the tricks, this is probably the easiest to disguise. Trick number two, I'm going to call this the Harry Kane. When the ball comes long from a goal kick, players will lean into the opposition when they jump to make them off balance and miss the header, and sometimes they can even win a foul from it. But this is a very dangerous tactic, and I think it should be penalised more harshly. Number three, we have messing up the penalty spot. When the opposition have a penalty, you'll often see players scuffing the penalty spot, hoping it'll cause them to miss the penalty and slip over. Trick number four, sweet talking the ref.
Looking well today, ref. I like the shirt. Cheers. You been working out?
Those players that are always in the ref's ear trying to keep them on their side. This job often falls to the captain in the hope the ref will be nicer to them later in the game.
Good off that ref, you did amazing there. Yeah, just keep it upright, just keep an eye on some of their players, alright?
Yeah.
And the final trick is time wasting.